Our reporter is visiting a wildlife park to see koalas. She'll check out the traditions of the Bor Luang Temple Festival, and then she'll head for a fish market. You're watching Guangzhou, Pearl of the South. In the densely populated city of Guangzhou, there's quite a few places to get closer to nature. One of them is the Xiangjiang Wild Animal World in Panyu District, which boasts a large area of pristine subtropical rainforest inhabited by many wild animals. The reporter is guided by Guangzhou native Cao Hantian.
现在啊，我就有小天陪同着，然后穿梭在丛林当中，好像到了森林公园一样，空气特别的清新。
对对。
那我们现在要去哪里呢？
啊，我们现在其实是去看动物。
看动物？ 对。
看动物不是在动物园看吗？
啊，这个动物世界呢，动物园精彩多了。
啊，有什么精彩之处？
你看我们现在其实是在坐的这个电瓶车上啊，然后是一路这么。 沿着这条小路就在走，然后我们可以看到有很多动物，就在那边。对，各种各样的动物就在我们周围。这边是鸵鸟，
看它离我们好近。Xiangjiang Wild Animal World covers 1.3 million square meters. Visitors can drive their own cars through the park or ride in golf buggies to see up close over 500 rare species from all over the world. Tourists need not fear for their safety. Aggressive animals are separated from the driving route with a moat. Five zones along the route replicate places like the Australian forests, the American jungle, and West Asian deserts. Just a minute after seeing kangaroos and ostriches from Australia, people can see South American llamas.
很快，要很快。现在车有点多，快来看吧。他们是吃青草，来，拿一点青草就喂喂他们。来，吃吗？来，尝尝看。他不吃，他又过午餐了。来，你吃吗？
乖乖过来，
来，
过来乖乖，
慢慢的靠近它，来，不吃，它不饿。我觉得呀，大自然之中，动物都是有灵性的，它会感受到你的友善。如果你非常友好的靠近它们，它们其实能感觉到你对它们传来的那种信息。我就是
好奇，
告诉它们说我不会伤害你的。来，
还需要一点时间。
这只在吃东西，你吃吗？
It's difficult to tell the difference between a llama and an alpaca, but a closer look reveals that an alpaca looks rather like a sheep, whilst llamas are taller in stature. Both belong to the camel family, are pack animals, and have wool that can be woven. They're important to the occupants of the South American plateau. From the park guidebook, people can learn the names of many unknown animals.
This is called Malaimu. It's lived in South America. It's
a
treasure. It's like Chinese cat, it's black and white. I think it has the same wish as a cat, and that is to be able to take a color photo.
The Malayan tapir is nocturnal. Its sight is poor, but it has a very sensitive long nose that it relies on to find plants and wild fruit. Its black and white skin is a good jungle camouflage. Here in this park, it's easy to feel closer to nature. Some of the brown bears frolic whilst others look bored. One may want to take a picture of this group of waterbucks. Zebras and giraffes, meanwhile, show the beauty of the African wilderness. After an hour, they reach the koala park. In 2006, just 6 koalas were introduced here, but now the koala family has 22 members.
它不是懒，不是懒，主要是它为什么睡这么长的时间呢？主要是跟它吃的这一个桉树叶有关。
为什么呢？
因为这个桉树叶它是有一种带有一种单宁，是有毒的一种植物来的，只有考拉能吃。它吃完这种植物以后呢，这种植物的纤维非常的高，营养量是非常的低，所以呢它必须得长时间的睡觉来保持体能。啊，想想看啊，一只考拉一天二十四个小时有二十个小时是在睡觉的，所以四个小时是在进食或者是玩耍。
啊，对。
我们既然捕捉到了它难得的进食时间，你看它在吃桉树叶。
对。
这是一个非常难得的机会，大家可以用手轻轻的抚摸一下它的背部，感受一下它的皮毛。它的皮毛呢是非常的柔软的。
那我摸它，它会反击吗？或者是？
不会，你只用不要摸它 觉得
摸起来软软的。
因为考拉的皮毛呢，在野外它的毛呢就等于它的雨衣，所以下雨天的时候呢，它的雨水呢都不会进到它里面去。它的毛呢非常密，可以防水的。水滴到它的身上，水都会滑下来，非常的密。
那考拉的性情是有攻击性的吗？还是？
不会，它们非常的脆弱。像在野外的话呢，它们在下到树下的话，如果是一条蛇经过，都能把它致命。它们呢是非常的脆弱。
它们是没有自卫的能力。
没有，没有。
They seem to need human protection. They look calm, but they cry like newborn babies if frightened. These gentle and slow creatures don't pose a threat to any other animal. Their cute shape and the smell of eucalyptus entices visitors to take a closer look at them.
太搞笑了，每天都进入深睡眠。我想请问一下，他都是这样待在树上
啊？对，
你们可以把它抱下来吗？工作人员
啊，可以叫我们工作人员抱下来，给你们近距离的再观看一下。
好好好，请工作人员抱一下。
啊，你抱一下给他看。
你是专门负责这只考拉的吗？
也不是说专门负责这只，因为养很多。
为什么你在抱它的时候要戴上这个皮手套呢？
它爪子很锋利，容易抓伤。
看一下它的爪，其实
看一下它的指甲非常的长，
因为它是抓树干的。所以平时
因为它的指甲不长的话，它不可以在40到50米高树杈上生活。
它是生活在40到50米高的树上。
是，那野外的话是这么高。在这里的话，我们一般是人工的嘛，没那么高。
近距离的看一下，
它其实真的很乖啊，都大部分时间都很安静的，一天里面。
正常来说是很安静，如果一般没什么事的话，它就会在树上里待着。
那现在把它抱回去吧。让它觉得安全的地方。这些都是它抓的吗？
这不是这种巨人，因为有其他小菜会怎么说影响到它坐或者爬树，这样就会容易摔下来，比较巨人。
你很酸吗？
肯定的，10来20斤了。
它有20斤。
20应该有，肯定。
8.4重。
对。
那它每
18。
17、18。
它是到。
Just because the koalas sleep for 20 hours a day doesn't mean the keepers have little work to do. They have to prepare fresh eucalyptus leaves and find good branches for them so that they can eat and sleep well.
它的怀孕期啊是非常的短，它怀孕期呢只有35天，它
一个月呀。
哦，对，所以呢，它出生呢其实也算是一个早产儿，它只有一颗花生米那么大，非常的小，没有视觉，又没有听力。可是呢，它也会包在育儿袋里面，然后就吸着妈妈的乳房，一直到5个月。这5个月呢，它是不会出来妈妈的育儿袋里面的，因为它非常的小。
Yeah, there are koala health examination rooms, exhibition halls, and a storehouse of fresh eucalyptus leaves. 4 generations of koalas have been bred here, and to ensure their healthy development, the staff give them regular checkups.
我跟小田啊，然后跟随着这边的工作人员小林老师进入了考拉的检查室，因为现在啊，考拉已经在广州繁殖了4代了，已经繁殖了4代了，那要做一些什么样的检查呢？
查查袋子，看看小岛情况。
啊，查查袋子。
因为它是那个考拉的母考拉的，这边有个育婴袋。
他会害怕吗？
有点紧张。
有点紧张呢，我们躲得远一点。老师您开始吧。这就是小考拉的腿吗？
对对对对，你看我们这是个母考拉，像它的育儿袋已经发育很好了。
嗯，哦，是看小考拉的育儿袋。
不，我们看一下这个袋子里面小考拉性别，判断一下小岛的性别，这已经是个母的了。
啊，已经可以明显的看出小考拉的性别来了。
对对对，
我觉得这是考拉妈妈。大概是知道孩子在自己的这个育儿袋里面，所以即使被
出于保护，
对，出于保护，他的动作非常的轻柔。嗯，你看他的绒毛已经长得很好了。
你看他的小脚啊，
小脚，小脚发育的怎么样？
发育的很好。
不过他现在
During the time the little koala stays in its mother's pouch, breeders give it a checkup every other week to find out how it's doing and whether the pouch is clean.
便于他握。那像这样的检查要多长时间进行一次呢？
我们是2周查一次袋。现在这段时间是6到7个月之间，它是，偶尔出袋，然后爬到大部分时间待在袋子里。那7个月以后呢？是大部分时间是待在妈妈的。
育儿袋里，
待在外面或者是爬到背上去。到8个月的时候呢，基本上全都爬到背上去了。然后有时候8个月开始就开始学习，
爬树啊，学习吃食啊。
这个阶段有一个非常重要阶段，因为他现在在逐渐的学习吃那种桉树叶，所以呢，他要吃一种从妈妈那个泄殖腔里分泌出来的一种流质性的粪便，我们称为 PEP， 他要吃那种 PEP 才能吃桉树叶，
就是保护他的肠胃。
接触有益菌，因为在桉树中含有一种物质单宁酸，单宁酸对其他动物来说都是有毒的，它只有吃了这种妈妈的粪便以后才可以抵抗这种毒素。
我觉得您每次的检查真的是非常的严谨而且又严格。
那老师都习惯了。
那老师可以
Koala health examiner Chen Shu-Ching studied koala husbandry in Australia for many years. It is she who brought the koalas to Guangzhou. She explains that little Ruby here is 7 years old and has given birth 5 times. This is perhaps the greatest reward for all her efforts. This tree branch is specially designed to measure their weight.
7.58公斤，16斤左右。那正常的考拉的体重是多重呢？
就是母考拉，一般母考拉的体重在4到8公斤之间。嗯，它带崽儿来生，小崽儿有一定的重量。
因为当了妈妈，它自身可能也加重了重量了。
基本上小崽现在有400克重了。
400克重了。那它宝宝的名字取了吗？
取了。
叫什么名字
？Jenny。
Jenny， 女孩子。Jenny， 希望你在广州能够过得好啊，好好照顾好你的小 Jenny。
Xiang Chang Wild Animal World has another animal nursery where baby animals are cared for. Special breeders look after them day and night. The most precious animal in this nursery is the Chua Hu, the snow tiger. It's more formally known in English as the stripeless white tiger.
它现在有多少只呢？
现在就是在我们。动物园现在只有六七十只，
那在全中国的范围内呢？
全中国应该也就不会超过100只吧。
不会超，太珍贵了。
对对，它比白老虎还要珍贵。
A snow tiger is an offspring of a white tiger, but with genetic abnormality. Unlike a white tiger, which has grey stripes all over its body, the snow tiger only has grey stripes on its tail and upper eyelids. And just as it is with the white tiger, this makes it difficult for a snow tiger to survive in nature. But here in this wildlife park, they've created a highly favorable living environment for the snow tiger. Once food appears, this cub forgets its shyness.
他现在对我们已经非常放心了。对，慢慢喝，慢慢喝。他一天得喝多少次？一枪的。一天喝6次。
要喂它。问他是定时定量的给他吃，我们就是24小时都有那个饲养员。那这里面是什么奶呢？这个奶粉是那种国外进口的狗奶粉。吃好了，吃好了，吃好了。
它永远都不够的样子。
The little tiger is certainly growing. It seems, however, that it never gets enough food. After finishing the milk, it moves on to the reporter's finger.
这个小动物嘛，一般都是我们从小接触大的，喜欢接触人。这边我们给它喂，喂食之后很喜欢和我们一起玩，就和我们舔我们的手啊。The
cub is not as wary of them as it was before and begins to show its naughty side. This could be because the reporter fed the cub, or perhaps because it's now full.
在我们这个动物幼儿园，一般都是在它有4个月大左右的时候，然后就送走了。在那个年龄段，它的那个自身的抵抗能力，还有那个它那个时候已经不吃奶，主要吃肉。
那一只小老虎跟您平常的这个相处的时间只有最多4个月。
对对对，
那
刚出生到4个月大。
刚出生有多大？小老虎？
刚出生的小老虎一般就是1000克左右。 1000克，对，1公斤，对对。那4个月的时候有几斤？4个月的时候，它应该有25公斤左右。
从1000克养到25公斤，从小老虎睁眼看到的第一个人是你。
对。
那送走它的时候，会不会舍不得呀？
是。
你等于
老虎爸爸了。因为它随着时间的推移嘛，它会慢慢的长大，然后一般都是感觉很有。
很有成就感，
有失爸爸。这种感，而且你养的是珍稀的，对，特别是这种比较珍贵的那种野生动物，我感觉我也是一种荣幸，能够做这个职业。
那有舍不得吗？有啊，但是我有的时候就是，
也会过去看一些那些从这里出去的那些长大的，
他们会认得你吗？
好像认不得了，但是你会，就是已经恢复那种野性了。对对对对。但其实我们最希望的就是这种结果，希望他们能够保留自己的那种野性，而不是过多的依赖人类。是啊是啊。没有。
At 1.5 months old, the cub is introduced to mincemeat. By 4 months, it will be given live animals to eat, so it can learn to survive and one day perhaps be reintroduced to the wild.
这个太娘了。
The traditional Borluo Temple Festival.
108单量。
The Chen Clan Academy.
这一排小房子。
You're watching Guangzhou, Pearl of the South.
正好赶上了他们一年一度的菠萝蛋，就是每年农历的2月11到13，祭祀海神的日子。那现在啊，正在表演的就是巴林南非常著名的这个莺歌舞。除了这个莺歌舞啊，还有非常多的民俗活动。To
celebrate the birthday of the sea god, a grand temple fair is held, accompanied by various ritual activities. This is the Sea God Temple in Miao Tou Village. By 9 a.m. on opening day, the place is already packed. People from other parts of Guangdong have come to join in the festivities, bringing along with them their own folk performances. A team of performers from northern Guangdong is performing a traditional folk song. The Yao people hold a ceremony to honor their ancestors and celebrate the harvest. The villagers blow ox horns and dance to the accompaniment of drums. Men wear red turbans adorned with feathers, whilst young women wear beautiful costumes.
Oh, no. 那结了婚的呢？
结了婚的就是刚才打折雨伞的那个，就是阿妮了。
哦，阿妮。
对，也就是结了婚的。
结了婚的，那我呢？
你呀、啊，带上这个雨，这个的话，那就是阿贵哥了。这个是阿贵哥带的。
哦，这是男孩子带的，叫阿贵哥。
The Yao Song Festival provides an opportunity for young people to seek partners. This is why there are so many beautiful young women and handsome young men.
来来，走那边去，那边跟。宝贝啊，你要带我去哪里啊？
These people performing the Heroes Song and Dance are from Jiaozi in eastern Guangdong province. Their routine is based on the 108 heroes from one of the four great classical novels of Chinese literature. People used to believe that such activities could ward off evil spirits and prevent disaster.
108单将，对不对？
哎，对，但是我们现在主将的是36天罡嘛。
36天罡，那你呢？你是谁？
杨志。
啊，你是青面兽杨志。那你呢？好，那你呢？
秦明。
秦明。好，那你们霹雳火秦明，那你们手上拿的这是什么呢？
这个就是我们表演的道具啊。
这，就是这样拿两个锤子敲一下吗？
不是，就是木棍。嗯，
我们里面总共有几个舞蹈法吧？嗯，啊，一个舞蹈动作，一个是扶棍，嗯，一个是餐棍，还有一个叫
那个逼棍，
背棍吧，还有一个双龙嘛。
双龙。
哎，双龙主要是由这几个动作组合成嘛。哇！主要是步法跟那个锣鼓声协调一致。
协调一致，那要怎么打呢？
我打你打给他看一下。
打给我看一下。
大就位。
Performers swing and rattle the wooden poles. The movements are forceful and impressive. Accompanying these two very masculine actors are two small performers. The festival's opening ceremony includes dances of dragons, lions, sea turtles, and fish. Having watched them praying for blessings from the gods, it's important to visit the sea god temple.
堕落蛋啊，已经有千年的历史了。那每年的这几天呢，广州人总喜欢逛逛庙会，还有来这座南海神庙拜一拜，这可是他们延续了千年的传统呢。
The temple is 1,400 years old. During the early Sui dynasty, the sea god's birthday was celebrated to ensure the safety of ships. Legend tells us that during the Tang dynasty, a merchant ship from the Indian state of Bo Luo arrived in Guangzhou, and that a man went ashore and visited the temple and there planted two kapok tree seeds. However, when he returned to the dock, his ship had already left. And from then on, he cried every day, hoping that one day his ship would return. Eventually, he turned into a stone statue. Today, he's regarded as a symbol of friendship between the Chinese and other nations. A statue of him was enshrined in the temple, and the temple became known as Bo Luo Temple. Subsequently, the birthday of the sea god evolved into the Bo Luo Temple Festival. In Guangzhou, this very cosmopolitan city, the grid of overpasses links together the cream of Guangdong culture. The next stop is the Chen Clan Academy.
In 高楼林立的广州城啊，有一座百年的古建筑，就是我右手边的这座陈氏书院，也叫陈家祠。站在陈家祠前，马上就被它屋檐上的这些精美的、颜色艳丽的雕刻所吸引了。没错，陈家祠啊，正是以著名的三雕两塑、一柱一彩而成为了集岭南工艺的大成之作。现在啊，我们就走进陈家祠。
The Chen family ancestral temple, first built in 1888, contains the finest examples of Guangdong's architectural and decorative arts. Locals say, if you don't visit the Chen family ancestral temple, then you haven't been to Guangzhou.
我听说那陈氏书院又叫陈家祠，
对，
那这到底两个名字哪个更准确？
其实我从这个整个祠堂的作用为出发点呢，当然是应该叫它是陈家祠。但是为什么我们现在抬头也看到写的陈氏书院的横匾呢？就是因为呢，清朝的官府呢是严禁地方建这么大的合族祠堂。对，然后当时的陈氏啊，陈氏的族人就把自己叫书院，是为了躲避检查。对。
The Chen family ancestral temple covers 15,000 square meters and has three courtyards. The first thing that catches the eye through the entrance is an exquisite wood carving.
这幅图案呢有岭南第一浮屠之称，因为很明显这是一个福字，但这个福字
这是用竹子
雕成的一个福字的。这个福字从中间拆开，左边是一个多字，右边是一个寿字，只不过它是草书的寿字，对，所以比较难看出来。
多寿，然后加在一起是福字，
对。然后呢，还有一个特点就是我们看的题款“青春发达，大器晚成”。那怎么样从这个画面看得出是这个意思呢？其实也很巧妙。我们看这边的竹子比较细，是幼竹。然后其实希望呢，年幼的陈氏子孙能够像幼竹一样青春发达。然后
大器晚成呢？
对，大器晚成就是因为右边的竹子是比较粗，很明显是老竹了。但是它的末梢是焕发了新叶。对，所以是希望陈氏子孙即使不能青春发达，也能够大器晚成啊，
以此来鼓励陈氏的子孙要多多努力。
The Chen family ancestral temple, noted for its exquisite decoration, has wood carvings that are simple but meaningful. In addition to these, there are clay sculptures and pottery, brick and stone carvings along the eaves and pillars. They add great beauty to the building.
慧兰，我发现进入陈家祠之后，每一个屋檐之上都有这样的雕塑。
对，没错，屋顶最顶端的就是桃树，而且亭台楼阁。
亭台楼阁这一排小房子。
对，这些桃树呢都是在佛山十万烧制的，也就是我们从明清开始就很出名的十万公仔，就广州人把它叫十万公仔。
这么精细的陶瓷，然后从石湾运过来，然后再粘到上面去。
对，然后这里上面呢，最顶端的这陶塑啊，一共有11块，然后它组成了一个花脊，一个很漂亮的，我们叫花脊。
Porcelain works from Shiwan are not as world-renowned as Chinese ceramics, but they were very popular in Guangdong during the Ming and Qing dynasties. A blossoming magnolia tree adds yet more beauty and vitality to the old building.
走过了这家陈家祠之后啊，看到了这么多精美的建筑工艺，我真的觉得非常感谢在100年前，然后陈氏的先人，然后建了这座陈家祠，然后给我们后人留下了这么一座艺术宝库。
Our reporter watches fish sellers throwing fish in a fish market, and she enjoys brilliant night views on the Pearl River. You're watching Guangzhou, Pearl of the South. Our reporter is going to visit the Huangsha Fish Market in what was formerly a dock in the city's Liwan District. In the 1990s, many expressways and railroads were built, and as a result, shipping gradually decreased. To protect their livelihood, the resourceful Guangzhou locals started a seafood business here. And today, it's the largest seafood distribution center in the south of China.
这个厂呢是一年365天，全天24小时经营的，没有休息时间。所以很多档口的人员呢都是白班和夜班两班制。那进出货量一定很大吧？对，一天大概是500吨左右。500吨左右，那有几个档口呢？400多户。那比如说像这样一家水产店的话。它一天的这个进出货量是多少？
这个他们交易的品种不同啊，平均来算的话，每间当铺呢大概一天都有1吨的左右的进出货量。
就这样，小小的一家店。
对对对，因为他们这些货类呢，在档口的时间不是很长，货到之后很快就会分散出去，分销出去。
The neglected dock warehouse was turned into market stalls.To prevent fish from dying during unloading, fish trucks drive directly to the stall entries. The first thing to do is categorize the fish.
I'm watching a magazine performance. Sir, just 完全抓起一条鱼来，然后就扔一个准。师傅，为什么要把这鱼扔到不同的水箱里面？
规格不同啊！
哦，规格不同，
价钱也不同
啊。价钱不同，像这个规格是多大的？
那是大条的。
大条的。
九两以上的。
九两以上的，一斤左右的，像这个水箱呢？
5-6两。
5-6两，这个呢？
8-9。
8-9，这个呢？
那个7-8。
那您都不用称一下啊？
不用啊。
那您
感觉的感觉，手感？
凭着手感掂量就掂量出来了。
是啊。
可是这7-8两、5-6两其实是非常轻微的差别，细微的差别，单凭手就可以掂量出来。
大条吗？
这个更大。您这是，如果是您打篮球的话，投篮一定特别的准。
我没打过。
没打过。像这个需要练多久啊？您在这边工作多久了？
6-7年了。
6-7年了，练就了一手的准头啊！来，我来扔一条。像这个是多重的？
这个8两。
8两扔到哪个箱子里？好。
看到，是啊。啊！哈
哈哈哈！扔鱼师傅啊，每天都是下雨天。哎呦。
是啊，每天都是下雨天。
This qualified worker handles 2,000 to 3,000 fish a day.To keep pace with the constantly expanding market, everyone here is as hardworking and as skillful as this man. Though their work may seem trivial, they quietly follow the tide of reform to promote changes in the market economy.
This 只龙虾呀，个头很大，所以呢，价格也非常的贵，在拿的时候要非常的小心。来看看它的背面
啊！The large lobster is too heavy to hold.
它要抱住我了！它要抱住我了！像这一只有多重？
八斤左右。
那它每斤价格是多少？
200多块钱，
这一只龙虾就要将近2000块钱。
The market sells both Chinese and imported seafood. To keep the marine products alive, a special pipe pumps natural seawater into the stalls. This keeps the seafood fresh.
这三只龙虾是您要的吗？啊，要运到哪里啊？
九楼啊。
是九楼，是广州的九楼吗？附近的。
打包。
那
像你每天都会来进龙虾吗？
是。
嗯，那除了龙虾还会进什么？
那些鱼啊，那些鲍鱼啊那些。
啊，鲍鱼。那像这个的话，一天三只，还是根据行情？
这不点货了，这如果有客人要的，有很多都要的。啊，
那离这儿远吗？
不远，就广州附近的。
啊，就在这附近的，所以说很方便。只要是客人点了龙虾，我们就马上，即使货源不足的情况下，也可以马上过来进。这种的，哪是老板啊？知道吗
？Close to the market, there are many restaurants, so people can buy seafood and have it processed here, or order it directly at the restaurant.
怎么抓
？Whichever way, they're assured of having the freshest seafood.
好了。
Our reporter buys two shrimps.She's going to have them cooked in a nearby restaurant. Guangzhou cuisine takes time and effort to prepare. First, the shrimp are fried in a wok. After they turn golden in the oil, they're taken out, and ginger, garlic, pepper, salt, and wine are added. The cooked shrimp not only look great, but the meat locked under the shell is delicious.
你觉得啊，像这样的海鲜就适合不顾形象一口咬下去。我觉得用椒盐做起来，好像因为是过过油炸过的，所以它的鲜味其实是被包裹在里面，没有流失。
没有流失。
它这个肉
很鲜嫩，
这个
鲜嫩。而且太厚实了，真的是加了椒盐，加了特别的料理，就会觉得哎，跟这个虾肉啊融合在一起了，非常非常的好吃。我觉得啊，这能够吃到了广州的千姿百味，还有活色生香。
Beyond the river, there's an area called Sha Mian, which offers a distinctly European flavor. The crew drives 2 kilometers further along the river to a dock in Yue Xiao District.While the boats here do ferry commuters across the river, they're chiefly for tourists.
For Guangzhou City, the most important thing to miss is its sunset. Now, the sky has turned gradually darker. The light has risen. Come with me to visit Fujian.
The best way to appreciate the city at night.Is by sailing on Guangzhou's mother river. Most of the city's landmark buildings stand along the river. Pleasure cruisers take tourists down a brilliantly lit 10-kilometer stretch from west to east. This boat charges 80 yuan a ticket.
白天在城市里靠着岸边看珠江的风景，到了夜晚呢，在珠江的风景里看这座城市。你看，在我左手边的就是小蛮腰广州塔。它自从建成的时候，每到晚上的时候都会亮起灯光，是吗？
对对，每晚都出现。
真漂亮，在夜空当中变换着颜色。
As the cruise ship moves slowly ahead, a truly picturesque landscape slowly unfolds. We see the impressive Sun Yat-sen University Gateway and the Xinghai Concert Hall.Which resembles a grand piano. The blinking neon riverbanks reflect a dreamy world that tourists find hard to leave.
夜晚的广州啊，在灯光的映衬之下，显得格外的旖旎。你看，这条珠江就像是一条缎带一样轻柔地环绕着这座极具南国风情的城市。广州啊，是古代的海上丝绸之路的起点之一，它连接着大海与内地。正是因为这样，让它也感染了一种像大海一样宽广阔达的精神。可能也正是因为如此，它在面对新鲜事物和外来文化的时候，显得格外的有包容力和接受度。也正是因为这样，广州会让你觉得极富地方色彩，又极容纳大方。
海浪洗刷了千年沧桑，才展现你向前的力量。海风吹化了千年的冰霜，才重现你停止的脊梁。多少目光把你遥望，你是赤子眷恋的故乡。多少双手把你开创，你是播种梦想的